Hey, Moon Magic Super Souls, welcome to your Moon Month Energy Update. Thank you so much for joining me. Welcome if you are returning and welcome if you're new. Every month I do this Moon Month Energy Update where we run through all of the different moon phases of the coming month, starting with the new moon. The next new moon that we are having in a few days' time is actually a new moon eclipse. It's in Libra. It's a very, very powerful, actually very positive set of dynamics on this day. Absolutely primed for manifestation. A ton of very powerful other astro dynamics going on though. So it is not without its intensity, interestingly enough. And as we move through the moon month this month, the different phases of the moon, which I will literally run you through all of them in a minute, there are some really strong spikes of energy. Now, curiously enough, there's also a lot of flowing energy as well, and also opportunity. Jupiter's going to move into retrograde. There's also opportunity to kind of almost, I think, to seek resolution in things. So if something shows up from the past, if there's an intense spike, your buttons are pressed, something is going on. I think this is a moon month where there will be real opportunity to actually start to put things down, lay things to rest, address things. Now, I'm going to touch base with a couple of what I would call key power points as well. For those of you that follow the channel, just a few weeks ago I had an amazing conversation actually with my younger sister Jocelyn, who's a brilliant astrologer. And she was showing us at the last full moon eclipse, basically the dynamics, the planetary collaborations that were going on for that eclipse moon. And they formed a kite shape. And as she was telling us, a kite shape, astrologically, is one of the most auspicious planetary collaborations we can have. So it marked a turning point or a point of a new beginning. And what she explained in that video is still available, that conversation, it's in Patreon now and on in the Moon Magic membership area. It's sort of an extra that I do those conversations, but I always put those on the main YouTube channel just for 48 hours or so, so everybody gets a chance to listen in. But she was telling us that this is a really auspicious collaboration. And at the base of the kite, which is pretty close to the end of Virgo, the turning point into Libra, so it's on the Earth's axis, whenever a planet passes that point, it's as though there is an opportunity to reignite your manifestations, your desires, your wishes, whether personally or for the greater collective. That eclipse moon kind of offered us a starting point. It left an imprint and we can utilize that energy. So I'm going to touch base with you because in October, actually on the 1st and the 29th, we have an opportunity. That's when the moon passes what I'm going to call that power point. So I'm going to put that into my Moon Month Energy Update as well. We'll look at the cards and the runes that were drawn in the Manifest with the Moon Astro Moon Diary. Lots of exciting news about that. Next year's, thank you so much those of you who have been asking me about them. I will bring up the cover for you in a few moments or in between some of the things that we're doing in this video so you can have a look at them. They are emerging. The reason it's taking a lot longer is because I'm actually collaborating with a software engineer. And what that means is, in principle, and we can actually definitely do this, we've tested the waters, we can definitely do this, we can actually produce more than one diary. So we can have a diary with UK dates, we can have at least one for America, possibly two, and we can have one for Australia. And it means that you can buy a diary that is closest to your time zone. So it means the information in it is accurate to where you are. And we are aiming, I'm not exactly sure how soon this is going to happen, but I mean, as soon as we can. I'd love it to be done by the beginning of the new year, but I'm also being realistic. We're aiming to have a website set up where all this information is available in a way that literally you could tap into it on your phone, put in your geographical location and find out exactly what is happening with the moon wherever you are. So if you go on holiday, you can just put in your new geographical location and you'll know exactly what is happening. You can tune into all this information. So when things are getting a bit intense, or indeed when things are flowing, whatever you want to know, to manifest with the moon, to align yourself with the natural rhythms of the way that the planetary influences sort of channel in through the lunar energy, you'll be able to do so. So it's really, really exciting. And I will say that 2025 and 2026 are seriously big years. I mean, I have been absorbed in the energy of 2025, and there's some amazing breakthrough times, but also some big packets of real intense energy as well, when I think, you know, things could seriously heat up. Sometimes stuff does have to heat up before we reach the breakthrough moment, but nevertheless, we've got a really interesting year ahead. I was actually saying to some of my students, I'm working on a tarot course, which some of you will have heard about. It's a huge course. Anyway, digressing from that, but I was talking to some of my students the other day and just saying, you know, I've always loved manifesting with the moon. It's why I made the diary and the journal, the Astro Moon Journal as well. So you can look at how the moon can influence your daily world and utilise that energy, you know, to your best advantage. Now, that's always been a passion for me. It's why I created those books. They're tools for living, tools for conscious living. 2025, quite honestly, is the first year I've thought, wow, this is perhaps really needed, not just a great thing to do and really amazing to enhance your life, but because there are such big astrological happenings. When they're happening, you know, we can honestly feel like we can feel overwhelmed or wonder what's coming next, you know, and actually next year is a year when things are going to heat up a bit. But within that space of heatedness, within that space of, intensity, there is so much potential to use this energy, to break through to higher levels of consciousness, different ways of seeing, being, doing. It is a year of profound potentiality, though it may not always be easy. So do watch out for the moment that the diary and the journal go live. I will let you know here on YouTube. And watch out for these key power points. When the moon passes the base of that kite shape, where there was an imprint of energy that we can utilize to kind of turbocharge our own manifestations and also our hopes, dreams, wishes, desires for the greater collective, for our planet, for the rest of humanity. And then the first of these is actually not very far away from the time that I am making this video. It's on the 1st of October. What I will do on the 1st of October is I will do a set of new moon eclipse readings. Although the eclipse isn't till the day after, I'm going to do them on that day, and I will talk about harnessing that energy, because the new moon eclipse is sitting on that power point as well. So it's a pretty exciting opportunity to touch base with energetically. So, beautiful souls, I am going to move on into the Moon Month Energy Update. Now, those of you who follow my videos here, usually I also do the All Zodiac Sign readings in one gigantic video. I do the Moon Month Energy Update, and then I read cards for every Zodiac sign for the coming month. I've done them separately this time, and we'll do so for a little while to see if that's helping and working better. A lot of people have been in touch with me and said, we didn't even know you were doing all Zodiac sign readings every month, and we didn't know where to find them. So I'm doing them separately, I'm uploading them. There are extended readings as well on Patreon and in the YouTube membership area, and we're putting them in playlists as well. So if you have a look at the homepage, hopefully you'll see it's starting to look a little bit more organised, and you should be able to pick a card readings as well that are asking specific questions. You should be able to find them much more easily as well. Trying to make the whole channel a better resource for you, where you can access information more readily and at your fingertips. You just have to click into the homepage, click on the playlist and scroll through, and you should be able to find what you're looking for really, really easily. Or at least that's the plan anyway. So tons of work going on here to kind of get information out to you in ways that make it just readily available. So enough of me waffling. Let's move to the overview, and I'm going to talk you through each of the moon phases. But first of all, let's look at the cards and the runes for the month, because they are so tuned into the overall flow of energy with such good guidance and advice in terms of how we navigate this kind of very interesting month, where we're going to have some very intense pockets of energy, but also the potential for a ton of productivity if we kind of use it really, really well. And whether, you know, it's sort of knowing when to put your anchor down and just rest up and just listen. And at other times when to really take action, seize the moment and get going. So, beautiful souls, I hope you enjoy your All Zodiac Sign readings, which are posted separately, and I hope that you enjoy this Moon Month energy update. Tons and tons of love. Let's move to the cards and the runes for the month. So these are the cards and the runes that were drawn for the month of October in the Manifest with the Moon Astro Moon Diary. And every year when I do the diary and the journal, I actually draw the cards and the runes first. And then I kind of dive into the way that the moon is moving and how she's connecting in with the other planetary dynamics throughout the month. And it always blows me away that the cards and the runes are so in alignment with the overall flow of energy. Because we are starting this moon month with an eclipse moon, a new moon, eclipse season is a portal which often actually connects us to both the past, the present, and the future. It's kind of like we get to look at the past to see how it affects us in the present in order to then potentially change what we do in the present to create a new and different future. And then we've kind of got to start to align ourselves and our actions, our thoughts, our words, our deeds, our actions with the future that we want to manifest. And that's kind of how manifestation works. Now, the first card of compromise says, are you in a situation where you need to make a compromise, or are you compromising too much? This card asks you to review your position and be sure to find a solution that takes the needs of all parties into account, including yourself. Now, we begin this moon month with a new moon eclipse in Libra. Libra wants balance. Libra wants harmony. Libra likes grace. We have the rune of Anzus signals. This is suggesting that things may be showing up in your world. They could press buttons from the past, or you could even be really quite actively having to deal with circumstances from the past that need wrapping up in your present in order to be able to shift and move forwards. So whether you are needing to be a little bit more flexible with your approach, or indeed you're needing to really stand firm and perhaps you've been compromising too much, this card is calling for equality, it's calling for balance, it's calling for fairness. And, you know, we can engage in self-reflection to really understand our own selves as the source of our own empowerment in our world. Now we have Anzus signals. This is about signs, signals, synchronicities. And that's also absolutely in alignment with eclipse season. Eclipse season is has a very karmic energy around it. The moon is sitting very close to the nodes. And that's how, you know, that's all that always happens at eclipse season. And the nodes are about the past, where we've come from, and the future, where we're going. And they have a real flavour of karmic kind of destiny, divine timing. So don't be surprised, especially at the beginning of this month, if things show up that feel as though you are returning to things in order to look at them again. This will be to address them and move forwards, including possibly letting go of things or dealing with things that might feel quite emotive, where you're needing to really center yourself and look at things through the eyes of grace. I'll come to this card in a moment. But you may have to stand firm. You may need to also be flexible. It depends what's showing up and how it shows up. But there is a window of opportunity to get really centered in terms of your own self-awareness of what you can do yourself in terms of manifesting your future and your contribution to the collective. That's the kind of energy that is around, particularly at the beginning of this moon month. Now, the card of grace says, when we sit in relationship with grace, we see every situation through the eyes of love, fostering our desire to meet life with understanding, compassion, and kindness. This card asks that you view your situation, or it could be any situation, with grace. Will understanding bring compassion? How would love view your possible choices? What would kindness suggest that you do? Now, this card is sitting with Berkana. Berkana is a rune that symbolises new beginnings. And it's not just like a new beginning, a door opens and there's a new opportunity. It's bigger than that. It's like a whole new phase of life, unwinding, unravelling in front of us. Connects me very much to this sort of PowerPoint event that is happening on the 1st of October, where the moon passes through the very end of Virgo and into Libra, and it lines up beautifully with the eclipse moon. But it's that PowerPoint at the base of the kite that my sister spoke about in the conversation we had. And that is the point when we can really invest our energy into lifting that kite. So it's kind of giving ourselves a turbocharged boost to raise our own vibration. Well, there is nothing like grace and gratitude, the two G's, to raise your vibration. Whatever is happening, if you can respond with grace, if you can respond with kindness, if you can respond with compassion. And remember, of course, kindness and compassion aren't wishy-washy. Okay, you may need to be flexible, but you may also find you need to be pretty firm over certain things. Kindness is not a wishy-washy, fluffy thing. It can feel that way sometimes, but sometimes kindness is really firm. It's kind of a real, actually, no, we're not doing that because that's not the right thing to do. That's not the kind thing to do. And actually saying no to somebody is a kind thing to do if they are getting something wrong. It's like saying no to a child who wants to have more sweets, and you know that if they eat them, they're going to be horribly sick and feel just dreadful. So saying no is a really kind thing to do. You're helping them to develop boundaries. So there's something around the energy this month about, it's kind of not what's happening, but how we respond to what's happening. How we address things so that we shift our energy and our contribution to the collective. Because Berkana is a big new beginning, it's a whole new phase of life. Berkana is symbolised by the birch tree, and the birch tree is often seen in cards. People use the illustration of the birch tree in cards that are about birth. The birch tree represents new beginnings. You know, if a forest is wiped out by a fire, it will regenerate, and it's the birch tree that generates first. It's a regenerative energy. So there's opportunity to regenerate through love, through understanding, through compassion, but also firmness, kindness, nothing wishy-washy about it. And that may mean that we have to be firm and say no to ourselves as well as to others. But this is going to herald and bring in the new. That PowerPoint that Jocelyn spoke of, we can energise that, that kite dynamic, the imprint of that. We can raise the vibration of us, ourselves, and of the collective. We can hold that higher vibrational perspective of the two G's, gratitude and grace. This is how we change the future. It's what we do in the here and now. You know, if something happens that feels a bit spiky or a bit intense, or your buttons are pressed, you can step away and view it through kindness, compassion. Maybe you send love and walk away, or maybe you're just very firm and say, I'm sorry, I'm not able to do that, that's not working for me, but you know, it doesn't change my care or thought for you, I wish you well. However we handle this, the imprint energetically that we are then putting into the world in the way that we handle it is what is then creating that new future. Are we bringing about a future that is all about kindness, compassion, understanding? Or indeed also including firmness, saying no to things that are not okay? Or are we kind of reacting, retaliating, feeding something that is, you know, discordant and making it bigger? Because if that's what we're doing in the present, that's the future we're creating. So this is what these cards and runes are really saying. This is what the dynamics this month are all about. So pretty exciting time if we think about ourselves as the source of change and ourselves as co-creators with the universe, bringing in what ultimately is the dawning of a new age. And we are bang in the middle of this period, this pocket of accelerated growth, where a lot is happening and a lot's going to be happening, especially next year. So beautiful songs. In fact, this seems a lovely moment to just pop up the covers for next year's diary and journal. I will keep you posted and let you know as soon as they are available. And there will be, as I said, more than one for different zones across the globe. I'm just waiting now for other people to organise the way that that kind of works and filters through the systems, the software systems, to make that possible. But I will let you know as soon as those diaries and journals are available. So, beautiful souls, these are the covers. Let's move on to the moon phases and look at the energy, the incoming energy throughout this moon month. Okay, so let's just acknowledge that October starts on the 1st with one of these key power points when the moon moves from Virgo into Libra. This is that base of the kite, when we can really energize our intentions and our desires and our wishes. So I would really be using this day at some point to get still, to drop into stillness, to get really focused and do some kind of a meditation where your focal point, kind of energetically, not just your thoughts, but also your feelings, are really aligned with everything that you want to manifest in the coming year, literally in the coming year. Eclipse moons kind of are not just in the here and now. They are a starting point. And what Jocelyn pointed out was that we do have almost like there's a year's cycle that is initiated by that last full moon eclipse. And it's these key power points throughout the year until September next year, when we can really harness that energy and give our wishes and intentions as kind of a turbocharge. The moon month officially begins with the new moon solar eclipse on October the 2nd or the 3rd, it depends where you are in the world, at 10 degrees of Libra, 10 degrees 3 seconds to be precise. In terms of personal potential and finding your unique place in the world, the dynamics of this new moon solar eclipse in Libra are seriously wow. This is a moon that encourages you to express your individuality while simultaneously recognizing your absolute interconnectivity with your fellow human beings and with all of life. So beautifully in balance. The lunar connections today promote conversations that matter, bringing an incredible opportunity to set your wishes and intentions that can literally shape-shift your world. And this is coming just after that PowerPoint. A Libra new moon naturally supports all aspects of balance and harmony, and especially in relationships, and this includes your relationship with yourself. And we have the added bonus of the eclipse energy, which opens that portal to enable you to understand how the past has affected the present, and then, in the power of the present moment, it gives you the opportunity to decide the shape of the future that you want to create. So have that conversation, whether this is with yourself or with others or both. And then craft your new moon wishes and intentions with clarity, with purpose and with care. Now I'm going to bring up the timings onto the screen now. And the purpose of knowing the exact time of the new moon is because the very best time to set your wishes and intentions is from the exact point of the full moon. This is when, for the full moon of the new moon, this is when the moon and the sun come together. It's like a sacred marriage, a sacred union. And it's from that exact point of conception, a meeting point of the divine masculine and the divine feminine, and for the 8 hours afterwards, that the energy is really primed to receive your new moon wishes and intentions. So that's why it's useful to know what the timing is in your part of the world. And hopefully these are enough of a selection of timings for you to be able to work that out from wherever you are on our beautiful planet. The moon then moves into her waxing crescent moon phase, and this is going to run from October the 3rd to the 9th, passing through Libra, Scorpio, Sagittarius and into Capricorn. And actually on the 9th, Jupiter stations direct and moves into retrograde. Now, following the stunning energetics of the new moon in Libra, this crescent moon phase heralds a period of significant personal empowerment. And this is aided by planetary alignments that are encouraging every aspect of your progress in every possible way. Now, even though the energetics of the 8th and 9th do suggest the possibility of underlying insecurities being brought to the surface, so this could be a little more intense, Jupiter begins the retrograde period on the 9th, and so this supports the expansion of what I would call inner understanding to assist you in overcoming any of these issues and to gently move forwards. It's very much what retrograde energy is about. It's movement inwards to address those internal issues. The moon then reaches her first quarter position on October the 10th in Capricorn. The energy of this first quarter moon actually has quite a serious flavour to it, but it's also in quite a productive way, asking you to be balanced and fair and just in all your dealings, and then from this, move your manifestations forward, knowing that you're on solid ground. The lunar influence suggests that if handled with this in mind, your communications and conversations, anything that arrives at this time, will actually assist you in establishing an incredibly solid ethical foundation, and this is going to enhance the future that you're building for yourself. So really worth approaching this energy from a really sound perspective and a very ethical perspective. The moon then moves into her waxing gibbous moon phase, and this is running from October the 11th to the 16th, passing through Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces and Aries. On the 12th, Pluto stations direct, and on the 13th, we actually have a approximately six hour void of course moon period when the moon moves from Aquarius into Pisces. So be conscious of this, because 6 hours is a time when it can have a noticeable effect on us. So when a void of course moon period happens, it's, as I said earlier, when the moon is in between two signs. So her energy isn't channeling through the personality of that particular sign. Now this can feel amazing and liberating, but it can also feel a little bit out at sea. Just depends what's going on for us at the time. Now this moon phase is a bit more intense. It begins with a big surge of energy on the 11th, almost like a growth spurt, fueled by passion and desire. Then we have Pluto stationing direct on the 12th, and this kind of adds to this momentum. This energetic then follows right through to the 15th. Now, even though this may feel a bit intense at times, the lunar influence during this period is actually suggesting the potential for significant transformation and growth. Now, on the 13th, we see a lovely underlying energetic inviting inquiry, and this can lead to a depth of vision that brings healing to any underlying issues or even old wounds that have previously been swept under the carpet. The intensity of the energy then eases on the 16th, bringing a much gentler but still strong energetic. And this is in the approach to the full moon, when the moon is gathering in momentum. So even though it's slightly more gentle, it's still quite strong. We're going to feel that build up to the full moon. We then have the full moon in Aries. This is at 24 degrees 34 seconds of Aries. And this is on October the 17th or the 18th, depending on where you are on our beautiful planet. Let me bring up those timings for you now. I personally find that if the energy is very intense in the build-up to the full moon, when we reach that exact point, I often feel I can feel the shift. It's almost like I can breathe again, or the intensity just suddenly diminishes. So really worth being conscious of this time if you are very, very sensitive to full moon energy. Now, a full moon in Aries will naturally ignite passions, and it's going to fire you up, bringing you energy and enthusiasm, everything you need really to move your creative endeavours forwards. The lunar influence today is distinct, with an energetic that is really calling you to bring in the new, and it also invites healing and acceptance with a view to find renewed hope and renewed optimism. The overall energetics of the day actually reminded me of the Serenity Prayer by Reinhold Niebuhr. God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. So it is quite a fiery kind of moon. It is quite intense, but tons of potential here. Now, because it's an Aries moon, and it's therefore often associated with fiery emotions, it would not be a surprise if circumstances show up that highlight strong emotions. However, regardless of whether these are strong passions of positivity or strong passions that connect to a difficulty or a challenge, however you look at it, you're being shown exactly what you need to see to get clear about what is flowing well in your world and also what isn't. It's then with full awareness that you can take charge and you can initiate a course of action. Very, very powerful day. The moon then moves into her disseminating or waning gibbous moon phase, and this is running from October the 18th to the 23rd, and she will pass through Taurus, Gemini and Cancer. Now, following the passionate and yet potentially enlightening energy of the full moon, the overall dynamics of this moon phase bring a relatively steady flow of productive and balanced progression. So this is pretty cool. On the 19th, we do see a slightly more impulsive energy coming in. So just be conscious of this. With self-control, a clear focus of intent and a bit of patience thrown in, the overall astrodynamics do suggest that this slightly edgy energetic could be harnessed into valuable productivity, and this can then gain significant traction as we move through this period to the last quarter moon position. So be conscious of this kind of little spike of energy that happens during this moon phase. The moon then reaches her last quarter position on October the 24th in Leo. Now, the energetics of this last quarter moon may actually leave you feeling as though you really want to make things happen and fast. However, rather like the process of giving birth, there are times when you need to push and times when you need to breathe. And today, the lunar influence would suggest that taking time to breathe will ultimately bring you the most productive outcomes, even if it doesn't feel like it in the moment. The moon then enters her balsamic moon or waning crescent moon phase, and this is running from October the 25th right through to the 31st, passing through Leo, Virgo, Libra and into Scorpio. And on the 26th, we do actually have a 7.5 hour void of course moon when the moon moves from Leo into Virgo. Now, having pressed the pause button at quite an intense last quarter moon, you can now press go. The lunar influence of this moon phase is creating an ideal environment to proceed. However, it is not an energy of full steam ahead, more the kind of progression that comes with playful curiosity and inquiry, kind of keeping you on your toes as well as on track. Between the 27th and the 28th, the overall energy suggests a call for evaluation. So if for some reason anything is happening that feels like a halt in your progress, use this time to assess exactly what is happening in a sensible and realistic manner. The 29th, which is also that power point at the base of the kite, when the moon will move from Virgo into Libra, the 29th then brings a distinctly karmic flavour to the day, so be conscious of signs and synchronicities and potential windows of opportunity. We are now also in the 4-day window of transformation and change that surrounds the energetic turning points of the Earth festivals. On the 31st, we celebrate Samhain in the Northern Hemisphere and Beltane in the Southern Hemisphere, both of which acknowledge new beginnings and a massive shift in the overall energy. So, you know, if in doubt, get still and meditate. Beautiful souls, thank you for joining me for this video. Tons and tons of love, and I hope it has been valuable to you. Don't forget to bookmark the page if you think you might want to come back, and just enjoy all zodiac sign readings as well. Tons of love to you all. Have an amazing moon month.